Low birth weight and high birth weight can be detrimental to the baby and the mother. So low birth weight is associated with increased risk of mortality and also conditions in later life. So there's a higher risk of cardiometabolic disease in infants who are born low birth weight, but also high birth weight comes with a range of problems as well. So it's important looking at birth weight from a genetic viewpoint, because if we know the genes involved in determining the trait, then we can better understand underlying biology. There are three main findings from the study. The first is we've discovered over 100 new genetic variants associated with birth weight, and we were able to determine whether those variants act through the fetal genome or through the maternal genome. The second major finding from the study is that we used this genetic information to show whether certain maternal environmental exposures causally affect offspring birth weight. So what we were able to show is that high blood pressure in mums tended to produce low offspring birth weight. Conversely, type 2 diabetes in mums tended to produce higher birth weight babies. And then the third finding from the study was this developmental origins and health of disease question. What we showed is that the observational correlation between low birth weight infants and increased risk of high blood pressure in later life was due to a genetic relationship and not due to developmental compensation due to intrauterine growth restriction. So what I mean by developmental compensation is that if there's an adverse intrauterine environment, then the baby's physiology changes, and that this has long-term consequences for growth, development, and eventually increased risk of cardiometabolic disease in later life. So our study is the largest ever genetic study of birth weight. So this was a large genetic study in over 500,000 participants, and it will be the definitive genetic study of birth weight for many years to come.